In this gem session, we'll show how to interact with Google Earth and create models using gem that will be placed back in the Google Earth environment. So first we select our site. I'm going to create a twister sculpture in front of this building here in New York. I'm going to select my site just by simply navigating to it and then going to SketchUp. I'm using SketchUp 7, it's the free edition from Google. And I'm going to use this Get Current View button from Google Earth. Basically, it takes the current view and bring it positioned properly into SketchUp. So you can see this is the view that we just picked. I'm going to create the base for my sculpture here. I'm going to draw it as a rectangular shape. I'm going to, let's say, position it here. The size will be 1 by 1 meters. And I'm going to extrude it 15 meters high. And by selecting the four sides of this sculpture, I'm going to create an export to DAE. So using export 3D model, selecting Collada format, DAE, like this. In the options, because these are simple rectangular shapes, I can disable this triangulate all faces. If you want to be on the safe side, you just triangulate everything. And we go to untitled DAE, that's the name. We can call it base.dae. Export it to file. And now we can navigate to gem and open this base file here. So we load a mesh file. We go to Collada format. And we select base.dae we just created. We're setting the unit to meters, so select yes. And we can visualize the faces. You can see that all the direction arrows are on the diagonals, so we can just simply right-click and join to get it all created as rectangular shapes. Now you can see that the direction is all over the place, so we can use the plugins profiler and set it all to align face by direction, choosing the y-axis, which is the upward axis in gem. So you can see that the direction is now is consistent. And we can now introduce some subdivisions. So I'm gonna just simply subdivide the model file like this. And again, using just to visualize how everything is oriented. Now I would like to create a twister sculpture. So I'm gonna use target points for that. I'm gonna start by selecting 2 points, the base of my sculpture and somewhere, let's say, about a third of the height or something like this, or maybe a quarter of the height. And I'm gonna start by first using echo to edge. I'm gonna set it to main and variable. And using echo to edge, allowing me to use two values based on the relationship to the target point. So one, meaning it stays the same size. And I want to multiply it up to 8 times of the original size. And you can see the result. It goes from the starting point, from the original edge, and pushes through. So we can see the result here. Now, in order to introduce a twisting effect, I'm going to use the face rotate about edge and by targets. You can see that it's still working on the main. And now I'm setting the rotation angles from 0 to 180 degrees and applying that. Now I created the twister function. You can see how the points of interest are in the game. They're basically these 2 points here. We can assign just an offset to that, let's say 0.5, something like this. We can use a component from a library or we can load something up. I'm just going to use a simple cube just for this quick example. And when I'm happy with that design that I created, I can then post it back to SketchUp and it will be positioned on site. So we generate a DAE file by saving it to a file, choosing DAE format, and exporting our file. We set the units to meters so it will be consistent with our original model. and we go to import it back in SketchUp. So we go to import, and we can navigate to GEM model DAE, and we've got the model positioned in place. When we want to send it back to Google Earth, we simply post in the model. So we place the model in Earth, and you can see that our model file is positioned on site. You can see that everything visible in the SketchUp session goes to the Google Earth model. You can see the SketchUp dude here standing right next to the sculpture we just created. So you could see the potential use of GEM for just creating integrated facades and so on. We'll see some of these examples created in additional video tutorials. So you can explore the designs you're creating in the context of the urban landscapes in Google Earth.